First Philadelphia cop in 40 years convicted for killing an unarmed man while on duty. Let's go ahead and put his picture up full mass, okay? A Philly cop has been convicted of voluntary manslaughter after he fatally shot an unarmed black motorist. Once again, first time in 40 years this kind of conviction has happened with someone who was on duty. Officer Eric Ruch Jr. was found guilty on September 21st for shooting Dennis Plowden Jr. This cop is the first Philly officer to be convicted of killing someone while on duty in 40 years and one of nine to have been charged in the past 50. In addition to the felony manslaughter conviction, this cop was also found guilty of possessing an instrument of a crime and faces up to 20 plus years in prison. Plowden and his wife, Tania Bond, who testified at the trial for a second time, seeking justice for her husband. Plowden was part of a high-speed chase that ended in a collision, left him sitting on a sidewalk in East Germantown. The cop believed Plowden was concealing a weapon in one hand, but afterwards it was revealed he had drugs in his obscured hand. Additionally, an investigation also determined the officers were chasing what? The wrong person. Details of the shooting. The cop alleges he believed he was in danger. Sounds familiar, right? He was in danger when he opened fire on Plowden. This happened December 27th, 2017. As the 25-year-old sat on the sidewalk, the cop said he noticed he had one hand raised, but the other one hidden. When officers at the scene told him to show his hands, he would not. According to CBS News, other officers gave testimony stating there was an element of danger in the altercation and could see how their colleague was justified in shooting. The prosecution said he was actually surrendering. Not knowing if Plowden had a weapon or not, and believing he would not be able to take cover if Plowden decided to shoot him, the cop discharged his weapon 6 seconds after arriving at the scene. The bullet went through Plowden's left hand and hit him directly in the head. Mr. Plowden died the next day from his gunshot wound. Despite testimony alluding to the justification for the shooting, the prosecution highlighted the fact that none of the other officers shot at Mr. Plowden and took cover during the detainment. Ruch, the cop who had spent 10 years in the police department, was not immediately fired. He was let go 10 months after the shooting. He had 10 more months to commit havoc, to kill somebody else. Let's put up a picture of the lawyer. Okay. This is the cop's lawyer. His name is David Mishak. Believes DA Larry Krasner's office was pushing for his client to be convicted of murder. Despite the DA, let's put up his picture. Despite the DA pushing for third degree murder, when the cop was indicted on October 9th, 2020, the charge was dismissed by the time of trial. Officer Ruch received the voluntary manslaughter verdict instead of the third degree murder count because the Pennsylvania crime code aligns his act with the lesser charges definition that says a person who kills an individual without lawful justification commits voluntary manslaughter if at the time of the killing he is acting under a sudden or an intense passion resulting from serious provocation. The cop should have been convicted of straight out murder. Now, keep in mind, so many individuals testified. Oh, the cop was justified. Oh, yes, yes, yes. There was an element of danger. Not buying it. There's a cop convicted now. This is a symbol of justice, but definitely not justice full throttle. We're looking for full throttle justice as it relates to people who are unarmed and killed in this community. All right, Adrienne, thoughts?
This is, as you said, it's not sufficient in terms of justice because the man was basically executed. Like this thought that also this claim, I should say, that we're always carrying a gun. It's like they think we're born with guns on our hands or something, but it's completely and totally nonsensical, nor is it indicative of what justice should be in terms of what police are supposed to do, again, to protect and to serve. And so I'm glad that there has been a conviction here. I think that's the first step, but preventing this kind of behavior to begin with, whether it's reducing police or ensuring that police are actually qualified to do their jobs, would be a great start.
Yeah, and I encourage everyone to follow the career of this DA. This is one of the best DAs in the country. That is my sentiment.